Students, today we will discuss the concepts of a new lesson called electrochemistry. What do you mean by electrochemistry, sir? Electrochemistry is the study of chemical reactions providing electrical energy or electrical energy carrying out chemical reactions. So we would say broadly, in the sense, it's the study of, or it's a branch of chemistry that deals with chemical reactions providing electrical energy or carrying out those chemical reactions using electrical energy. When I say carrying out those chemical reactions using electrical energy, the chemical reactions are non-spontaneous, which cannot take place on its own. So those reactions which cannot take place on its own can be carried out using your electrical energy. So it is the study of electrochemistry is the study of conversion of chemical energy to electrical energy or electrical energy to chemical energy. When I say chemical energy, it's called carrying out chemical reactions. Now in this topic, we are going to deal with types of cells, two types of cells. When I say cells, there are two types of cells. One is electrochemical cell, the other one is electrolytic cell. Electrochemical cell, the other one is electrolytic cell. In electrochemical cell, we have chemical energy converted to electrical energy. Whereas in the case of electrolytic cell, electrical energy gets converted to chemical energy. So that's the basic difference between the two types of cells. Electrochemical cell, the chemical energy gets converted to electrical energy. Whereas in the case of electrolytic cell, the electrical energy, we pass current, and hence electrical energy gets converted to chemical energy. That is, it gets, when I say it gets converted to chemical energy, it carries out some chemical reaction to form new products. And those reactions which are not spontaneous, which cannot take place on its own, those are called as non-spontaneous reaction. Those chemical reactions which are not spontaneous can be carried out using your current. And such cells which carries out the chemical reaction by the passage of electricity is called as electrolytic cell. So that's about the classification of your two types of cells. Children, now we are going to deal mostly in this lesson with the type called as electrochemical cell, because we have to generate electricity from chemical reaction. That is the point of interest of this lesson called as, of this topic called as electrochemical cell. Now the first and foremost electrochemical cell to be discussed is called as Daniell cell. What is Daniell cell, sir? It consists of two compartments. One is anode compartment on the left hand side and cathode compartment on the right hand side. We have two compartments, anode compartment and the other one as cathode compartment. So the next compartment is, the second compartment is cathode compartment. Now in the anode compartment we have electrolyte, so called aqueous zinc sulfate solution. So it contains aqueous zinc sulfate. In the anode compartment we have aqueous zinc sulfate solution, whereas in the cathode compartment we have aqueous copper sulfate solution. In the cathode compartment we have aqueous copper sulfate solution. So anode we have zinc sulfate and the corresponding cathode we have copper sulfate solution. At the anode we dip what is known as zinc rod. So zinc rod is dipped in anode and copper rod is dipped in cathode. So this is copper. Copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution and the corresponding zinc rod is dipped in zinc sulfate solution. Children, this is the basic diagram for the Daniell cell. And we need to close the circuit by two ways. one we have to close the circuit through the electrodes, and the other one we have to close the circuit through the electrolyte. And in the case of electrode, we simply connect by means of wire. So the externally electrodes are connected by means of simple wire, whereas internally the electrolytes are connected. The electrolytes are connected by means of a system called salt bridge. This is known as salt bridge. A inverted U-like arrangement is called as salt bridge, which consists of jelly mass of, which consists of gel mass of or jelly mass of your aqueous potassium nitrate solution. Aqueous potassium nitrate, or it can be even aqueous sodium chloride, potassium chloride, and so on. And externally, in the external circuit, the current is because of flow of electron. Externally, it is because of flow of electron, whereas internally, it is through the electrolyte, through the by the electrolyte, through the salt bridge, it is the flow of ions. So therefore, the current is consumed or the current is conducted internally by the way of flow of ions, whereas externally in the wire by the way of flow of electrons. Now, when we dip zinc in zinc sulfate, your zinc rod, zinc dissolves in zinc sulfate to form zinc 2 plus and 2 electrons, and the electrons are accumulated in the zinc rod, and therefore the electrode is called negative electrode. And negative electrode here we call as anode. In the case of electrochemical cell, the negative electrode is called as anode, and anode, the loss of electron takes place. Loss of electron is called oxidation. So therefore, children, anode oxidation takes place. AO, A stands for your anode, O stands for oxidation. When both are vowels, A and O both are vowels, it is easy to remember. In the corresponding cathode compartment where copper rod is dipped, copper 2 plus from the solution accepts 2 electrons from the cathode and get deposited as your copper. Copper 2 plus accepts 2 electrons and gets deposited as copper. So here zinc rod loses electron, whereas their copper 2 plus accepts 2 electrons and gets deposited as copper. Gain of electron is called reduction. So at cathode, reduction takes place. At cathode, reduction takes place. Now, what is the overall reaction? The overall reaction is when you sum it up, 2 electrons, they get cancelled, and therefore zinc plus copper 2 plus will give you zinc 2 plus copper. When I say zinc, it is solid. When I say copper 2 plus, it is aqueous. When I say zinc 2 plus, again it is aqueous because it is an electrolyte. When I say copper, again it is solid. So that's about the overall reaction of your Daniell cell. Children, now in this overall reaction, the concentration of the aqueous system, the concentration of the salt in the aqueous system is taken to be 1 molarity. So here the concentration is taken to be 1 molarity. In a similar manner here also, it is maintained to be 1 molarity. Now, during this reaction, during the course of the reaction, a potential difference is developed. Because of this chemical reaction, a potential difference is developed between the 2 electrodes, zinc and corresponding copper. Due to this potential difference, there is a flow of electrons from zinc to copper. The electrons, this become negative electrode, and because of the accumulation of your copper 2 plus on the copper and then absorbing electrons from the cathode, the copper rod acquires positive charge, and therefore we call as this is cathode, this is anode, and this is cathode compartment that we have already seen. It is called cathode. Now, because of the flow of, because of the accumulation of zinc rod, there is a flow of electrons from zinc to copper. So flow of electron is from zinc to copper, and there is a flow of current in the opposite direction. Current flows from copper to zinc. Now, whenever there is a flow of current, there should be a potential difference, and the electrical potential or the electric potential developed between these two is called as EMF of the cell. it is called as electromotive force. When I say electromotive force, it is not a force, it is a work done in moving the charge from one end of the cell to the other end, as you should have seen or studied in your physics. Electromotive force is not a force. By name it is called as force. It is electro, electron, motive, motivating force. For the motivating force for the electron to come from one electrode to another electrode is called as driving potential. Here it is called as electromotive potential, or EMF. Now, it was found, the EMF of the cell was found to be, the standard EMF of the cell was found to be 1.1 volt. How do you measure this, sir? We can just connect this to a voltmeter and find the potential of the cell, which is said to be 1.1 volt. Now, whenever we say that the net potential is 1.1 volt, it is the potential difference between the corresponding electrodes, or each electrode contributes a particular chemical reaction. At each electrode there is a contribution of particular chemical reaction, and these chemical reactions, they involve a corresponding potential. The sum of these two potential, the potential of this reaction and the potential of the oxidation reaction and the corresponding potential of reduction reaction, constitute or the totality, the sum of these two is called as EMF of the Daniell cell, and which was practically found to be 1.1 volt. That's about the fundamental construction and the half cell reaction. We call as anode compartment here, that is called anode half cell reaction. We call as cathode compartment here, it is called cathode half cell reaction. When I say half cell reaction, it is that reaction taking place at a single electrode, not the total overall reaction. This is the overall reaction of the cell, and the each reactions, zinc giving zinc 2 plus plus 2 electrons, copper 2 plus plus 2 electrons gives copper, the individual reactions are called as half cell reactions. Children, that's about Daniell cell. Now, how do we go about understanding the corresponding representation of the cell, and how do we calculate this value of E naught cell in terms of individual values? When I said the total potential is nothing but sum of the potentials of these two reactions. So, one has to understand what potential is contributed by zinc alone, and what is the potential contributed by your copper 2 plus reaction. Copper 2 plus getting reduced to copper. Therefore, that idea of finding the individual EMF of the half reaction is called as single electrode potential, which we will see soon. Now, the next idea of interest, before going to single electrode potential, we have to understand the concept of what is known as representation of a cell. IUPAC, IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemists Association, they have given a beautiful representation of cell. Cell should be represented how? The representation of the cell is given as follows. Number one, the first point is, I would write cell representation. Number one, two compartments, anode compartment on the left hand side, double slash cathode compartment on the right hand side. This double slash represents what is known as salt bridge. This represents what is known as salt bridge. It need not be slash, it can be a straight line. I have just put it as slash. So, double line represents what is known as, double vertical line represents what is known as salt bridge, which separates the two compartments, so called anode and cathode compartment. Right. Now, within the anode compartment, we have reactions taking place, zinc giving zinc 2 plus. Therefore, zinc, the corresponding electrode and the electrolyte, they are separated by a single vertical line. Again here, copper 2 plus becoming copper, copper 2 plus copper. The electrode and the electrolyte, this is electrode and this is electrolyte in the anode compartment. Our electrolyte and the electrode in the cathode compartment. The electrode and the electrolyte, they are separated by a vertical line, and the vertical line indicates the region of boundary between the electrode ending and the electrolyte start. Therefore, it is the region of boundary between these two layers, and And similarly, the single line here represents the region of boundary between the electrolyte and the corresponding electrode of the cathode. Right. Now, the next point, we have mentioned the corresponding ions, zinc 2 plus ion and copper 2 plus ion, and we have to mention the concentration of the ion in aqueous solution. The corresponding zinc exists as solid for single vertical line, zinc 2 plus, it is aqueous. When I say aqueous, we have to mention the concentration here. The standard concentration of Daniell cell is said to be 1 molar, which I already illustrated. Similarly, again double slash, copper 2 plus aqueous with a concentration of 1 molar, single slash, copper, which is solid. Children, not only this sufficient, we should also express the corresponding EMF value. The EMF value of the cell, the standard EMF value of this cell, we call as E naught value, or E naught of this cell will be equal to 1.1 volt. When I say E naught, it is EMF measured. EMF measured at standard conditions of concentration, 1 molarity, and if at all the gaseous system is there, then the pressure should be 1 bar or 1 atmosphere. Both bar and atmosphere, they are almost equal, children, because 1 atmosphere is 1.0132 bar. It is very, very nearly the same. And in the case of your liquid, we have to mention the corresponding concentration. For standard EMF, the temperature is room temperature, that is 25 degree C. When I say 25 degree C, it is plus 273, which is 298 Kelvin. That is about the representation of your cell. Here again, we have just represented the corresponding Daniell cell in this particular system. Now, we shall see the next concept of interest called as single electrode potential. Single electrode potential is the idea of finding the individual EMF of the half cell, the individual EMF of the half cell. And we should also understand how the EMF of the entire cell is being obtained. That is our next point of interest. Right. Now, when I say EMF of the cell, I committed myself that it is a total EMF of the system. When I say total EMF of the system, it is EMF of the oxidation of cell and the corresponding EMF of the reduction of cell. Therefore, children, now we have to identify the total EMF. Let me say I have the corresponding zinc 2 plus, copper 2 plus, bar copper. E naught of this cell will be equal to E naught of the conversion zinc to zinc 2 plus plus E naught of the conversion of copper 2 plus to copper. So, the sum of the EMF involved in each of the half cell, the sum of the EMF involved in each of the half cell is called as the total EMF of the cell. But children, now in this case, zinc getting converted to zinc 2 plus. When I say zinc getting converted to zinc 2 plus, it is called oxidation. Copper 2 plus getting converted to copper, it is called reduction. So, in one of the term, we deal with oxidation, and in the other term, we deal with reduction. To homogenize both the potential, it is convention given by the IUPAC to express both as reduction potential, either express both as reduction potential or both as oxidation potential. In our text of interest, the tabulated for standard EMF of any half cell is always given as standard reduction potential. So, therefore, when I say standard reduction potential, both the terms should be expressed in terms of reduction potential. Hence, what we do, children? We write E naught of cell will be equal to the second term, we keep it as such because it is already the reduction reaction taking place. Copper 2 plus plus 2 electrons gives copper. When I say gain of electron, that is called reduction. Whereas in the case of the first one, it is oxidation reaction taking place, and when I convert this oxidation representation as the reduction form, then we have to put a minus sign. Therefore, changing the sign, it becomes E naught of zinc 2 plus bar zinc. Now, you see, children, your zinc 2 plus bar zinc, it is represented as reduction. Similarly, copper 2 plus bar copper, it is again reduction. Both the potentials now represent what is known as standard reduction potential. Whereas in the previous expression, which is absolutely true, this equation gets turned to this because of homogenizing the individual terms representing what is known as standard reduction potential. Now, this is also correct, but this is here one of the term we express in terms of oxidation potential, whereas in the other term we express in terms of reduction potential. To make both the terms to be expressed in terms of reduction potential, we convert the oxidation reaction cell in terms of reduction potential with a minus sign. Therefore, the equation becomes E naught cell will be equal to, I would say, E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper minus E naught of zinc 2 plus bar zinc. This can be written as E naught cell is equal to, I would say, this is cathode, copper 2 plus bar copper, that is the actual cathode of your Daniell cell, and zinc bar zinc 2 plus is anode of a Daniell cell, and therefore we say E naught cell is equal to E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. We can also represent as E naught cell will be equal to E naught of right hand side, that is right, minus E naught of the compartment or the cell which is on the left. So E naught of right minus E naught of left, or E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. In this case of Daniell cell, it is E naught of standard reduction potential of copper to that of minus standard reduction potential of zinc. Now, I have put not everywhere representing what is known as standard reduction potential. If we simply represent E cell, which is at some other temperature, E cell will be equal to again E of cathode minus E of anode. We can also represent E cell is equal to E of cathode minus E of anode. That's about your representation of your cell, and as well as the corresponding standard EMF expressed in terms of the individual EMF values. Now, it is our duty for our zinc 2 plus bar for the Daniell cell. We have already illustrated that by experimental value, your E naught cell was found to be 1.1 volt. Therefore, E naught cell is equal to 1.1 volt. For your Daniell cell. Now, children, how this 1.1 comes into picture? That is very, very important, and that is known as the combination of your E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper minus E naught of zinc 2 plus bar zinc. Now, let us analyze the concept of your individual EMF of the compartment, and that is known as single electrode potential or EMF of half cell. That is what the next point of interest we call, what is known as single electrode potential. So, the next topic of interest is single electrode potential. I hope, children, you will be understanding the concept properly. Please make a note of this information carefully without leaving any of the material. Right. The next topic is single electrode potential. Now, we have already said E naught cell is equal to 1.1 volt for your Daniell cell. Also, we have given the expression that E naught cell will be equal to E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper minus E naught of zinc 2 plus bar zinc. Now, it is our duty to calculate the individual value of your cathode half cell EMF and the corresponding anode half cell EMF. How to calculate the individual values are? Now, for this, if you have to find this E naught cell value, can be found using the experimental value, so called using potentiometer, and the individual half cell cannot be directly calculated. Always half cell potential can never be calculated. You can always calculate only the complete cell potential. Therefore, if by some means, if you are able to make one of the terms zero, if one of the term is made zero, then the experimental value found, the E naught cell value found will directly give what is known as the E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper. Or if this value is made zero, then whatever the value which we find using your potentiometer experiment will give you directly the corresponding E naught value of the other electrode. So it is our duty to make one of the cell as a standard cell whose EMF is zero. So to find single electrode potential, we use standard hydrogen electrode. The standard hydrogen electrode is called a SHE, which is nothing but your hydrogen adsorbed in a platinum, gas, the hydrogen gas adsorbed in platinum with a pressure of 1 bar. Therefore, the pressure of the hydrogen gas is 1 bar, and again the concentration of the ion in the system is 1 molar. So this is what is your platinum, of course, solid. This is what is known as the representation of your SHE, that is standard hydrogen electrode. The E naught value of SHE, E naught value of standard hydrogen electrode is considered to be 0 volt. Why it is 0 volt, sir? Because both the reactions taking place at the anode and cathode of your E naught cell, that is SHE, will be similar reaction, the same reaction taking place, and therefore they get cancelled out. Since in the when I say standard hydrogen electrode is used, it gets oxidized. When the reaction is an oxidation reaction, then what will happen is your hydrogen will liberate electron to form H plus. In the case of reduction, H plus will accept electron to form hydrogen gas. So the reactions are equidirectional property. The reactions are absolutely opposite, and they are, the compounds are exactly the same, and the idea is they have same concentration also. The concentration is maintained throughout. The H plus concentration at the oxidation and the reduction end, they are maintained throughout, which is 1 molar. Now, what is the construction of your SHE? When I say the construction of SHE, we have a compartment in which we have a platinum rod which is connected to a platinum metal plate, and this is again coated with platinum black. Now this is again which is placed in a closed container, in a closed system, not a container, in a closed system, and there is a let out, a passage for hydrogen gas to come inside. So hydrogen is pumped from outside, H2 gas, which is at about 1 atmosphere pressure or 1 bar pressure. Now these hydrogen gas, they come out, come through the passage, and they get adsorbed on this particular, they get adsorbed on this particular platinum foil. Now this is in contact with a solution of hydrochloric acid or any other acid, in which the concentration of H plus ion is 1 molar. The concentration of H plus ion is 1 molar. That is what the simple construction of your SHE, and E naught of SHE is taken to be 0 volt. Now children, we have illustrated that SHE has 0 volt. We have also illustrated the simple construction of your SHE. Now we shall try to understand how single electrode potential using SHE can be calculated. At the first instant, we connect your platinum solid adsorbing hydrogen gas at 1 bar pressure connected to acid at aqueous, which is 1 molar concentration, double slash representing your salt bridge. Now this SHE, this entire can be singly written as SHE. This SHE is connected as anode because it is on the left hand side. Now, what is the cathode of a Daniell cell? We know that cathode of the Daniell cell is your copper, and therefore we connect copper 2 plus bar, copper. This is again aqueous with 1 molar concentration. This is solid. Now, the E naught cell by your potentiometer experiment can be found. E naught cell is experimentally found as 0.34 volt. Therefore, what is the mathematical expression of E naught cell? It is E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode, and therefore E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper minus E naught of Xi will be equal to 0.34 volt. E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper, that is the cathode, and the corresponding anode is your Xi. Now, children, we know that E naught of Xi is 0, and therefore E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper minus 0 will be equal to 0.34 volt. Therefore, the single electrode potential of the Sander reduction potential of copper was found to be 0.34 volt. That is one of the value for your Daniell cell. Here one value we have found. Children, there is a difference between this E naught cell and this E naught cell. This is for the entire Daniell cell. So, this equation E naught cell represents the E naught cell for entire Daniell cell, zinc bar zinc 2 plus, copper 2 plus bar copper. Of course, aqueous, solid, everything you can understand. Now, so this E naught cell and this E naught cell is not the same. This is for the Daniell cell and this is for the cell which is written here. In a similar way, we can connect the Xi on the right hand side. I simply write Xi. So, therefore, the second case is zinc 2 plus bar zinc, that is the vertical line zinc, which is aqueous, again 1 molar concentration. You have Xi on the right hand side, the E naught cell. Now, again the E naught cell value was found to be, here in this case it was found to be 0.76 volt. It was found to be 0.76 volt. Now, what is the value of your E naught cell, children? E naught of right hand side, that is cathode, Xi, minus E naught of left hand side, that is your anode, which is your zinc 2 plus bar zinc, which is equal to 0.76 volt. Therefore, 0 minus E naught of zinc 2 plus bar zinc will be equal to 0.76 volt. This implies E naught of zinc 2 plus bar zinc, which is called as standard reduction potential of your zinc, which is equal to minus 0.76 volt. That's about the individual single electrode potential being found by using the concept of or the usage of what is known as Xi. Xi is standard hydrogen electrode. Now, children, for want of space, I'll just clear off this particular area and we'll try to understand how your E naught of Daniell cell comes into picture as 1.1 volt. Right. We have found E naught of copper 2 plus bar copper as 0.34 volt and the corresponding zinc 2 plus bar zinc as minus 0.76 volt. Substituting this value in the previously found expression, E naught of Daniell cell is 0.34 volt minus of minus 0.76 volt. Therefore, children, it is 0.34 plus 0.76 volt, which is equal to 1.1 volt. That's about the concept of single electrode potential being found, which is utilized to understand the idea of what is known as E naught of cell, which is called as Daniell cell. So, children, I hope you should understand this concept properly because we have taken almost all the concepts in this idea. Now, if at all you need to have much more clear clarity, please once again read the textbook and do write and practice. Unless and until you write and practice, you won't be in a position to understand this concept properly. Children, that's all for the end of the day. We will see in the next class for further concepts. Thank you. Bye-bye.